Good morning, students. We will continue with the how to insert audio and video in HTML. In last lecture, we discussed there are two methods to insert audio in HTML. First is with the help of embed tag. And second way is with the help of audio tag. So both of these tags are used to insert audio in your HTML. In the case of your audio, it is an empty tag. Like look at here, embed tag start. Then you will give the source of the file. Then there are some more attributes which we can use, like controls. If you want to show the control buttons, autoplay, if you want to autoplay the audio. But remember one thing, in some browser, this attribute is not accepted. And next is loop. Loop means when your tag audio is complete, after that it will restart. So this is embedded tag. But in the case of your audio tag, first of all you will have to use audio tag. It is a container tag. Inside audio tag you will use autoplay, then loop, then controls, and height and width. Okay, height and width. In the same way, in embed, you can use the height and width of your audio content, audio control. And after that, you will use one more tag, source, and src equal to name of the audio file, and then at the end you will close audio tag. So this is the way. But in case you want to use insert video, so remember one thing, video is a there are different format of a video file. So look at here, video we can use with the help of again two tags. One is embed tag. In the case of your video, again, we have two tags. One is embed tag. And in this auto start, yeah, auto play in some time. Yes, Vijay. Yes. Mumika, you want to say something? Okay, beta. In the case of your embed tag for video insertion, there is a auto start, not autoplay, but auto start is the attribute. Then volume controls, then loop. Okay, these are the attributes. I will send this. Notes to you better. Now in the case of your embed tag, you will use source equal to the name of the file. Your video will be inserted. Another way to insert video is with the help of video tag. So you will choose, look at here, one is embed tag and another is in place of it audio, you will use video tag. So in the video tag, again, there are control, source, height, width, autoplay. These are the same thing. So I have created one coding. Look at here. I have used here video tag. I set height and width, then control, then source. Source equal to name of the video file. So I am saving this and running this. So look at here. My first control is of audio. Second control is of video. So this is...
Good morning, students.
Yeah, look at here. This is a video. Okay. So this is the video. And I have inserted this video with the help of video tag. So look at here. So this is, remember one thing, auto play, auto run, these attributes are not working in some browsers. Okay, auto play means automatically when we open the browser, video will automatically execute it. Yes, Bhumika.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, Bachche.
सर एक बार आपने जो कोडिंग ऑडियो में करवाई है ना
भूमिका यस कंप्लीट योर क्वेश्चन बेटा यू नीड द कोडिंग अगेन बेटा So look at here, how you can insert audio, here typing coding. This is your audio tag. Controls means you want to see the controls on the screen. Autoplay here, it is not working, but in reality, in some browser, they are working. Autoplay means automatically starting of your audio. You will source tag, then src, name of the file, okay, the mp3 file, and then you will close audio tag. So this is the way we can insert here. Audio tag is a container tag, but your source tag is an empty tag. In the same way, here we use audio for inserting video, there is a video tag. Yashit, is it clear, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, next topic, which I am going to, which is very important, that is CSS. So, first of all, I want to check your prior knowledge, Raghav.
Yes, sir.
But what is CSS?
Sir, CSS is used to design web pages. As HTML is used to provide a format to web page, CSS is used to design the web page, present it in a more beautiful manner, and add more qualities to certain tags.
Raghav, we can use the formatting with the help of HTML. We can font color is there, font face is there, so many things are there. Then why we need CSS?
Sir, CSS helps us to accurately work on certain tags.
This is not a exactly
the style sheet language.
No. Now, I am going to discuss why we use CSS. Then I will discuss what is CSS. Okay, Raghav?
Okay, sir.
First of all, remember one thing, CSS provide us unique formatting. So I am first of all giving you one example. Suppose I have created one website, school website. So school website, we know that if I open the school website, so here is a school header is here. If I open any particular web page, the school header remains same. Now, I create the website of Swami Sundha Public School. I have, suppose I have a web pages 50. And in these 50 web pages, I use header means H1. That is, in all the web pages, Swami Sundha's Public School. And its color is red, and its font is Arial, and it is italic. Suppose I have 50 pages HTML. I have created 50 pages, and in 50 pages I will use I have used H1 tag, font tag, and so many other things. Formatting features are there. If principal ma'am say the color of Swami Sundha Public School must be blue in place of red, and font must be Times New Roman in place of Arial. Now tell me, what is the solution? What is the solution to solve this problem? Harshit. Yes, Harshit. If I want to apply some changes in the web page, and total web pages are 50, how I can edit these web pages?
Sir, I have 50 web pages mein changes karne padenge.
Yes, this is the main reason. In reality, in any website, I am taking one example, that is a 50. But in reality, if you count in the web pages of any website, so it may be around 1000, or because there are so many activities are there, so many circulars are there, so many things are there. So it is not feasible for any web developer to do work with the help of only HTML to format, because formatting work will be very lengthy and it will not provide us common editing, common formatting. For this, we have CSS. Now, ways we will create CSS. In this, we will define the design. And in HTML, we will not provide any type of formatting. But what we will do here, we will import CSS file, designing file. So automatically, whenever in 50 web pages, if I in 50 or 1000 web pages, if I have imported the CSS, if I make any change in CSS, automatically there will be changes in 50 or 1000 web pages automatically. It will provide us unique data, and moreover, formatting will be very easy because you are controlling the CSS. You are not controlling the multiple HTML web pages. Yes, it's clear. Concept is clear. Yes, Yashit. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, beta. So this is the main reason why CSS is important. Whenever you are doing any professional, you are a web development, you need CSS. Even in school website, CSS is created. Otherwise, without CSS, present time, web development is not possible. So if you without CSS, you can create one or two web pages, but CSS provide us more formatting features, more formatting tags. For example, if you want that your image have a border, dotted border, dash border, different type of borders, and these type of things can be used only with the help of CSS. So CSS have two important things. One is common formatting we can provide on the web pages. Second one is it provide us more features, more components, more type of you can say features as compared with HTML. In HTML, we can change the color of the font, we can change the color of a style of font, we can change the size of, but there are so many things are there. For example, text spacing is there, there is a word spacing there, so many things are there that can be done only with the help of CSS. So the full form of CSS is cascading style sheet. So what do you mean by cascading style sheet? Any student, raise your hand. Cascading, what is the meaning of cascading? Bhumika,
so repeat the question.
What is the CSS? The full form of CSS is cascading style sheet. What it means? Cascading effect kaun se hote hain beta? What is cascading? Yes, hurry up, beta, give the answer. Raghav,
quick styles.
Repeat,
quick beta. Styles.
No, it is not. Now I am telling about what is the meaning of cascading in normal English language. Cascading. What is cascading? Yashit?
Sir, overlay effects. Like
cascading effects, you can say ki beta jab aap किसी एक के परफेक्ट करते हो तो उसका इफेक्ट ऑटोमेटिकली दूसरे के ऊपर होता है. फॉर एग्जांपल देयर आर सम वाइकस लाइक साइकस पड़े हुए हैं. यस माधव इज देयर. यस बेटा माधव, यस गिव द आंसर.
सर व्हेन वी मेक चेंज इन एनी स्पेसिफिक वेब पेज द चेंज ऑटोमेटिकली अप्लाइज टू अदर वेब पेजेस.
ऑटोमेटिकली इफेक्ट ऑन अदर्स बेटा. फॉर एग्जांपल देयर आर सपोज 10 साइकल्स आर देयर. If we push one cycle, automatically its effect will be another cycle. So, ek cycle ke effect dusre pe hoga, fir dusre ka second ka third pe, fourth pe. This is called cascading. So, automatically effect on other component. Theek hai, this is called cascading. In the same way, cascading here means if we make the changes in one place, automatically changes will be another place. That is cascading. And the full form of CSS is cascading style sheet. Okay, so there are three type of cascading style sheet. One is external, internal, and inline.
Sir, please once repeat the meaning of cascading.
Beta, cascading effect means automatically effect on other component. If we make the changes in one component, automatically other component automatically affected. Okay, beta. Ye dekho beta, one minute.
Yes, sir.
1 minute, beta. It means beta, like pass on to the success of other means effect on other component. Maine abhi iski na ek aap dictionary meaning se better ye hai ki aap iski example jo maine abhi aapko di thi ki इफ देयर आर सम प्लेइंग कार्ड्स एंड वी स्टैंड देयर, एक अगर हम उसको एक प्लेइंग कार्ड को गिरा देते हैं तो बाकी के भी गिर जाएंगे. इन द सेम वे इफ देयर आर सम साइकल्स आर देयर, इफ यू पुश वन साइकिल एंड इट विल इफेक्ट ऑन अदर साइकल्स. तो एक के ऊपर अगर हम कोई इफेक्ट करते हैं तो दूसरे कंपोनेंट के ऊपर भी उसका इफेक्ट हो, उसे हम कहते हैं कास्केडिंग. सो इज इट क्लियर बेटा?
यस सर.
ओके बेटा. सो इन HTML in CSS, there are three type of CSS are there. In external CSS, internal CSS, and inline CSS. So now, I'm going to create one internal CSS. Okay? So look at here. I use HTML tag. I use head tag. In head tag, title equal to title CSS. Now, in this, I give one attribute within head tag style. Attribute is type text / CSS. So we are saying this is a CSS because styles are used for different purpose. Here I am using style tag for CSS. And here I use H1 because I want to make changes in H1 tag, curly bracket start, curly bracket close. This is the body of your CSS. Here I use color colon blue. This is the later on I will discuss their attributes, their values, but I define the color of H1 is blue. And I take here font size. First, I am using only single feature beta here. I close the style. Head tag, I use body tag, and I use here H1. Here I have not defined any color here of H1. I type here SSDPS, then I close H1 tag, then I again use H1 tag and calendar. Then I closed body tag and then HTML. I am saving this in desktop. Extension is, suppose I am taking here CSS HTML dot HTML. I save this file. I open the file in browser. So look at here. I have not given the color of SSDPS and Jalandhar in H1. I have not given here. But even then, the color of H1 is blue. And this is due to the CSS coding, which we have defined under title tag, under head tag. And remember one, in this web page, if I am using here multiple time H1, its color will be H1. So I want to use here for H2, I want the color is green. What I will do here, H2 color is green, and suppose in my web page I have used H2 two times automatically its color will be green. I am saving this. So look at here. If I want to change the color, simply I will change the CSS in place of green. I take here yellow. So my formatting will be common, and moreover, I can quickly change the coding. Is it clear, students? Concept is clear. Yes, Bhumika, Daksh, Harjot, Harleen, Harsimran, Jaiditya, Kavyansh, Keshav, Kavish. If you have any doubt, you can raise your hands. So this is the coding of CSS. Now, who will tell which type of CSS, internal, external, or inline?
Internal.
Yes, internal. Because why internal? Because
excuse me, sir.
Yes, beta. Why it is internal? Because it is used in the same web page in which we want to apply the effects. क्योंकि ये इसी वेब पेज में है. That's why it's called internal CSS. So if you have any doubt, you can raise your hands. So this is our internal CSS. Now, if I want to give some more features, I will have to use semicolon and then second attribute, second command of CSS. Suppose I want to take font family. Not here is not font face, font family, and then Vardhana. So look at here. So look at here. Font style is different. So this is called internal CSS. So note down the coding. At the end, last command, no need to.
Sir, I'm fail notebook. पर क्या करना
है? बेटा, I will give you one assignment. You will do that. Okay. This is your in last command. You will not use semicolon, but in other commands, if I want to insert one more command, I will have to use semicolon. It means. This is a separator. Semicolon is here is a separator. Suppose I want to give here my suppose we or maine iske upar feature apply karna hai.
Suppose italic
iska font ka size le lete hain. Font size equal to colon 20 px So look at here, I can increase this size in place of 20 pixel. I am taking here 100 pixels. Look at here. in the case of your HTML, maximum size is H1, or in case of font, it is 7. So this is the feature of CSS. Look at here. So student, time is over. I am closing the meeting. So tomorrow we will continue with this topic. Take care. Bye, better.